and you will find him waiting. The Prince of Life is there. He flows in the river, soars on the summer air. His love is all around you. The Prince of Life is there. Open up your eyes. Breathe the air. The Prince of Life is everywhere.
Good morning. My name is Mike Silberg. I thank you for joining us this morning. The title of this talk is Jesus and the Beatles Explode into History. I got my Beatles tie on, a yellow submarine, and one of Leona's Beatles Fab Four paintings. Anyway, we're going to start with a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for all the blessings you give us every day. And we thank you that you are a man of history. And that's what we're going to talk about in this talk. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. On February 7th, 1964, the Beatles landed in JFK Airport in New York City. It was like a bomb went off. Thousands of fans were waiting for the Beatles at the airport, and thousands followed them wherever they went. Besides their music, their charm and wit captured the imagination of the young generation. At first, many credited the disc jockeys and handlers that launched the Beatles to have made them so popular. But when it was time for the Beatles to come through, they did. 2 days after they landed in New York, they performed on the Ed Sullivan Show to a record audience. Almost half of America tuned in. I was 10 years old at the time and watched them perform with my sister. Somewhere she had heard that they liked jelly beans, so she was actually throwing jelly beans at the TV. 2 months later, the Beatles had the top 5 songs on the singles records chart, a feat never attained to by any other singing group before or since. It was the Beatles' music that made them so popular, not the DJs. Nobody knew it at the time, but the Beatles had just triggered off a cultural revolution that would end up causing social and political upheaval for years to come. You know, the reason why I'm mentioning this is because the same thing happened to Jesus in the city of Capernaum on the Sea of Galilee. At the start of Jesus' ministry, after he had been baptized in the Jordan River, this is what happened. The following is from Mark 1 and the Gospel of Luke. Jesus went to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach. The people were amazed at his teaching because he taught them as one who had authority, not as the teachers of the law. Just then, a man in their synagogue who was possessed by an unclean spirit cried out, "What do you want to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." "Be quiet," Jesus said sternly. "Come out of him." The unclean spirit shook the man violently and came out of him with a shriek. The people were amazed and they asked each other, "What is this? A new teaching and with authority? He even gives orders to unclean spirits and they obey him." Like the Beatles, it was like a bomb went off. News about him spread quickly over the whole region of Galilee. That evening after sunset, the whole town gathered at the door. A few days later, when Jesus returned to Capernaum, the people gathered in such large numbers there was no room left, not even outside the house. Jesus and his disciples were not even able to eat, yet the news about him spread all the more, so that crowds of many thousands gathered, so much so that they were trampling on one another. Twice it is recorded how many people were actually in these crowds. Jesus miraculously fed crowds with loaves and fishes that numbered 4,000 men in one instance and 5,000 men in another. Women and children weren't counted at that time, so the number could very well have been closer to 10,000 in each instance. That's from Matthew 14:14-21 and 15:29-38. Jesus and his disciples stirred up the same kind of frenzy the Beatles stirred up when they first came to America back in the 60s. Everybody for miles around had to come see this Jesus. Some wanted to get healed. Some wanted to hear the words Jesus was speaking, but a large part came for entertainment and just for something to do. Back then, they didn't have TVs or movie theaters or the internet to look at. Jesus was something sensational. He was someone to go see and be entertained by. There were so many people, it was beginning to get out of hand. It was becoming a circus. If this happened today, there would be vendors selling popcorn and t-shirts and souvenirs. Hey, get a loaf of Jesus' miracle bread for only a dollar. Hurry up. Get them while they last. Excuse me. It got so bad that Jesus was being disrespected not only by the people that just wanted to be entertained and get something to eat. Jesus was being treated poorly even by the people he healed. In Luke 17, Jesus healed 10 lepers, but only one came back to thank him. Jesus responded, were there not 10 cleansed? But the 9, where are they? Jesus became so tired of ministering to people that didn't appreciate him, he began to speak to them in parables without giving them an explanation. The following is from Matthew 13. The disciples came to Jesus and said, why do you speak to them in parables? Jesus said, to you it has been granted to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not. Therefore I speak in parables because they don't want to see. They don't want to hear. They don't want to understand. The following is from Matthew 11. Jesus denounced the towns in which most of his miracles had been performed because they did not repent. They did not listen to him. Woe to you, Chorazin. Woe to you, Bethsaida. And you, Capernaum, will you be lifted up to heaven? No. You will go down to hell. For if the miracles that were performed in you had been performed in Sodom, it would have remained to this day. There were many thought that the Beatles were a flash in the pan and wouldn't survive the test of time. They have survived. 60 years later, in 2023, just last year, they had a song reach number one in sales on the UK song chart. Many thought Jesus wouldn't last either. It is on the level of a carnival sideshow. The leaders of Jesus' day thought if they killed him, that would be the end of it. That would be the end of Jesus. It wasn't. The following is a description from an archaeologist named Titus Kennedy of how Jesus' life has impacted history since his death. Jesus has had an overwhelming historical impact. The name of Jesus and the story of his life are known to billions of people. Typing Jesus into the Google search engine will yield approximately 665 billion results. A recent global internet search results study by Stony Brook University ranked Jesus number one in searches, clearly demonstrating the prominence of Jesus in the modern world. One could argue that because of Jesus' art, architecture, literature, medicine, politics, economics, society, religion, science, and therefore all history has been changed forever. The calendar system that most of the world uses is based from the birth of Jesus. The Gospels, which describe the life and work of Jesus, are the most well-known and documented writings from the ancient world. How did this happen? Initially, the followers of Jesus included only a few disciples, but by the end of his life, this number had grown to thousands. The number grew exponentially. In just over 300 years, Jesus had gone from relative obscurity in an empire steeped in idolatry and paganism to becoming the God that this empire followed and worshiped. The effects of this large-scale transformation can be seen in the centuries that followed. The followers of Jesus brought forth the establishment of monasteries and universities and hospitals and medical libraries and training schools. Jesus had a profound effect upon society, especially regarding equality. While typically in the ancient world, it was the elite men of royalty who were seen as those of the most worth in society. But as the teachings of Jesus spread, these ideas were replaced with new ideas of human worth, dignity, and rights. Jesus included women in his inner circle, associated with the outcasts and the poor, blessed children, and disregarded economic or national status. Because Jesus showed that every human being is made in the image of God, his followers understood that all people are of equal worth and deserving of love. It seems uncanny that Jesus, who lived in a tiny, out-of-the-way part of the Roman Empire, who was shunned by both the religious and political establishments of his time, to this day continues to influence the entire world. Many may disregard the teachings of Jesus, but no one can deny the tremendous and unparalleled impact Jesus has had on history. The Beatles are still here after 60 years, but Jesus far more so. Has there been any other person in human history with a larger impact than Jesus Christ? The answer is no. 2,000 years later, millions and millions and maybe even billions regularly read the words of Jesus and believe him to be the Son of God. Think about it. We are living in the year called 2024 AD, which means the 2024th year of our Lord, or the 2024th year from Christ's birth. That says it all. Jesus has exploded into history far more than the Beatles, far more than any others. He has exploded into history like a spiritual nuclear bomb. May the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord make his face to shine on us and be gracious to us. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon us and give us his peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
He gave you freedom.
Beatles were huge in the 60s and still are big, but nobody is like Jesus. He's impacted history more than anybody by far.